What's up, everyone? Welcome back for the next race. All right, gonna be rocking out on fucking Tokyo, so this is gonna be awesome. It's gonna be awesome as fuck. All right, definitely looking forward to getting ready to rock and roll. Alright, let's get this fucking show on the road. I thought it was clear. Oh, thought I could make it there. So close, but not quite. Nice. Whoa, shit! Alright, that was interesting. Oh, fuck. Yeah, it turned a little too early there. It's fucking stupid on my part. Oh, shit. There we are. That actually worked out somehow. Oh shit! Yeah. Definitely was gonna hit the wall there. Oh shit, I thought there was a shortcut over here. Which I think there is, but still. Wasn't sure exactly where it was. So I fucked up there, because I hesitated. Oh shit. Whoa, shit. Got really fucked up there. Yeah, I know. Ah, shit. Yeah, fuck. Whoa, shit. I fucked that up big time. Jesus. That sucked. Yeah, one car got in my way. Otherwise, I would have been able to nail that turn perfectly, but there was a stupid car in my way that I was trying to avoid. Oh, well. Still got fifth. At least I didn't get dead last. Yeah, that sucked. That one stupid car hadn't been there, I would have been able to nail that turn and probably would have walked away at least like second or third. That fucking sucked. Oh well, shit happens, right? Yeah, it is a cool-looking car, though. More of an old-school car. I think it's a 1964 Chevy Impala, I want to say. Yeah, my current car is a Chevy. I drive a, like in real life, I drive a 2003 Chevy Malibu LS. Awesome car, too. Definitely not bad, especially compared to my old car. My old car was a 2002 Nissan Sentra GXE, and that was a great car in the sense that, like, it was very reliable overall. But at the same time, that particular car, at least under the hood, as far as, like, the reliability of, like, the motor and shit, was really good, but it wasn't very strong, you know? I mean, it was a basic four-cylinder, you know, had, like, 112 horsepower or something. So, I mean, not downright terrible, you know. It's not as slow as, like, you know, like a Fiat 500, which those cars should literally just be destroyed. That car just, like, wasn't very fast or remarkable in any way as far as, like, you know, the power of the motor. Whereas my new car, my 2003 Chevy Malibu LS, it's a 3.1 liter V6, so I mean, it's got a little juice. It's got 170 horsepower, so it's got a little bit more balls to play with, which is kind of nice. The only problem is that it burns a lot more gas than my old car, which is why I totally love that the gas prices are going up. So thanks, Joe Biden. Yeah, I love how back in the day, like from 2008 to 2016, whenever you had any problems, you could just say, thanks, Obama, and just blame it on Obama. Now it's going to be, thanks, Biden. So that's going to be fun. Probably going to say that a lot throughout the next 4 years, or realistically 2 years, because let's be honest, kind of doubt that Biden's going to last for four fucking years. I hope he does, though. I actually do hope that, you know, Joe Biden does last for his entire term. You know, he stays alive for his entire term. You know, and I may be a moderate conservative, but, like, you know, I never wish, like, any genuine, like, ill will towards anyone on the other side, you know, on the other side of the political spectrum. I wish them nothing but the best. I really hope that, you know, Joe Biden does a good job as our president. I want him to succeed, you know. I want him to do good things for the country. Whether or not I think he's going to, that's a whole different story. But, you know, I wish him nothing but the best, you know? And I feel like that's, like, part of the problem with things these days is that, you know, people on either side have just lost any respect for people on the other side, and that's a problem, you know? We all may have our disagreements at the end of the day, but We're all Americans, you know. We should all come together and just, you know, not be such dickholes to one another. Then again, though, what the hell do I know about politics? After all, I'm just some stupid kid who sits around playing video games all day. It's not like I know anything about anything, to be fair. I know I don't like paying $3 a gallon for gas, or whatever it's up to by now. I know that for sure, though, so hopefully they do something about that in the future, like maybe uncancel some pipeline. But again, what the hell do I know, right? But yeah, I picked a bad time to buy a car that has less gas mileage than my old one. Totally worth it, though. Having the extra horsepower is totally worth having to pay, you know, more for gas. Totally worth it. Alright. Well, either way, guys, that will do it for that one. So stay tuned for the next race and all that good shit. So yeah, stay tuned and until next time, peace out.